We were both young when I first saw you. I close my eyes and the flashback starts. I'm standing there on a balcony in summer air. See the lights, see the party, the ball gowns. See you make your way through the crowd and say hello. Little did I know that you were Romeo, you were throwing pebbles.
Why is there so much slide beats? Why is she going left?
Riding on the staircase, begging you please don't go. And I said, honey, you'll take me somewhere we can be alone. I'll be waiting, all there's left to do is run. You'll be the prince and I'll be the princess. It's a love story, baby, just say yes. So I sneak out to the garden to see you. We keep quiet.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the bride. Please be seated. Good evening. My name is Jeff Mysak. I'm the official officiant, and this is my first wedding. I'm a little nervous, and I need to take a deep breath. But if I'm the only one who takes a deep breath, I'll become even more nervous. So if you don't mind and indulge me, can we all take one collective deep breath?
Thank you.
Dearest family and friends, on behalf of Jesse and Tiffany, a most sincere and heartfelt welcome. You are each here today because of a role you've played in their lives. During what I promised to be today's short and efficient ceremony, I would invite you to consider how that role you've played in their lives will continue or possibly evolve. As you look to support them in their life together, and as you consider that role, I would also invite you to share your hope for Jesse and Tiffany. As you arrived, you received an index card. As you experience today's ceremony, please write on the back something you hope for Jesse and Tiffany. So when times get tough, they will have a keepsake they can look to. And always know we are out here hoping for them, hoping for the best for them. So, hope and love. That's what today is about. That's what life is about, hope and love. You guys are going to take care of the hope part. That leaves love. I guess I'm stuck with love. What is love, really? Well, I'm not a love expert. So when Jesse and Tiffany asked me to officiate their wedding, I went to school. I started asking and listening and reading and consulting experts, trying not to screw up today. And guess what? 3 short months, I got a doctorate. I became a love doctor. What did the love doctor learn? Well, it's actually pretty simple. Love is a choice. And love is a commitment. Love is a choice, and love is a commitment. You choose to love or you choose not to love. Unfortunately, today's society teaches us that love is uncontrollable and that it just happens, but that's actually not true. Love is a choice, and love is a commitment. Now, we'll get to the commitment part in just a minute, but sure enough, as my education went on, I learned the first part of most every marriage ceremony is the declaration of intent, which is when the bride and the groom publicly declare in front of all of us their choice for who they want to marry. So Jesse and Tiffany will now declare their intent, their choice. Are you guys ready?
It's too late now.
Do you, Jesse, welcome Tiffany as your wife, offering her your love and your encouragement, your trust and your respect, as together you create your future?
I do.
And do you, Tiffany, welcome Jesse as your husband, offering him your love and your encouragement, your trust and your respect, as together you create your future?
I do.
So I feel bad. And I have to confess, I'm not actually a love doctor. And what's kind of odd is life really is all about love. And yet we don't spend much time learning about love. Well, most of us don't. But Jesse and Tiffany know about love. In fact, they've selected two of their favorite readings about love. Today's first reading will be read by Valerie Bozich. She is a friend of the bride and groom, as well as the mother of the ring bearer.
Hello. The first reading is from the book titled The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. When he looked into her eyes, he learned the most important part of the language that all the world spoke. The language that everyone on earth was capable of understanding in their heart. It was love. Weddings get me every time, I swear. Hey, something older than humanity, more ancient than desert. When the boy felt at that moment was that he was in the presence of the only woman in his life. And that, with no need for words, she recognized the same thing. Because when you know that language, it's easy to understand that someone in the world awaits you, whether it's in the middle of the desert or in some great city. And when two such people encounter each other, the past and the future become unimportant. There's only that moment and that incredible certainty that everything under the sun has been written by only one hand. It is the hand that evokes love and creates a twin soul for every person in the world. Without such love, one's dreams would have no meaning.
Today's second reading will be read by the sister of the bride and the maid of honor, Christy Knott.
Hi, everyone. Make this a little
longer. Oh, I'm so sorry. Thank you.
The second reading is from the book titled A Man Called Oath by Frederick Beckman. Loving someone is like moving into a house. At first, you fall in love with all the new things, amazed every morning that all this belongs to you, as if fearing that someone would suddenly come rushing in through the door to explain that a terrible mistake has been made. You weren't actually supposed to live in a wonderful place like this. Then over the years, the walls become weathered, the wood splinters here and there, and you start to love that house not so much because of all its perfection, but rather for its imperfections. You get to know all the nooks and crannies, how to avoid getting the key caught in the lock when it's cold outside, which of the floorboards flex slightly when one steps on them, or exactly how to open the wardrobe doors without them creaking. These are the little secrets that make it your home.
So again, you guys are taking care of Hope, right? I hope. When we talked about love, I actually also want to talk about numbers. Did you know numbers are important to Jesse and Tiffany? Did anyone know that? Yeah. Any idea what numbers are important to Jesse and Tiffany? The number 5. As in, only 5 minutes, Jeff. That's how long I want the ceremony to last. I'm sorry, Tiffany, you asked the wrong person to be the officiant.
Never call me out.
How are we doing, though? We're okay, right?
It's too late.
The number 80 is important. It's our average life expectancy, which means the number 50 is the approximate number of years you will be married to one another. 18,250 is another number. That's the number of days, approximate days, you will be married. Or, for a very happy marriage, Jesse, That's 18,250 I'm sorries. But the number 8 is the most important number to Jesse and Tiffany. And it's why we are here together on this day, today's date, 8/18/18. Many cultures and traditions believe the number 8 to be lucky, which is very cool. But I can tell you after meeting with this couple and talking about the wedding and values and life and love, they don't need luck. They know each other. They know each other's strengths and they know each other's weaknesses. They know each other's wants and they know each other's needs. Tiffany knows that Jesse is steady and persevering. He's decisive and direct. He's independent, persistent, and innovative. And Jesse knows Tiffany is highly structured. Did everyone in the bridal party follow the 18 spreadsheets? You guys got that right? Okay. But Tiffany is conscientious and always interested in doing what is right. She is persuasive and she is articulate, and she is very strong on matters of principle. They already know these things about each other, and it's part of why they made the choice to love each other. So that's the easy stuff to love. But remember, love is both a choice and a commitment, which is important because with all of our strengths come a challenging side to us. For example, did you know Jesse can be very resistant to change? Or when he runs out of patience and energy, he reaches a bursting point and explodes. Or he just disappears and avoids the conflict altogether, or both. And when Tiffany is challenged, oh boy, she will go silently, collect all the data, all the proof, and come back and bury you with fact after fact after fact until you learn your lesson. But the even more cool thing is they both also know this about each other. They know the nooks and crannies and how to avoid getting the key stuck in the door and which floorboards flex. They know each other's imperfections and they've chosen to love those imperfections. That is commitment. Choosing to love the unlovely parts of each other. Committing to love each other when it's hard. That's what love is. That's what mature love is. That is the kind of love that comes from the hand that evokes love and creates the twin soul for every person in the world. That's the kind of love we all should commit to. And so now we come to the commitment, to the vows, the point in the marriage ceremony where you, Jesse, and you, Tiffany, commit to loving each other forever, no matter what. No matter how many Pokemon cards Jesse collects, or how many Air Jordan shoes he buys. Are you ready?
Hell yeah.
Please repeat after me. I, Jesse, take you, Tiffany, to be my lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, for as long as we both shall live. I, Tiffany, take you, Jesse,
to be my lawfully wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better or worse,
for richer or for poorer,
in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish,
for as long as we both shall live.
And now the rings, please. Tiffany, take that. No, sorry, Jesse, you take that. Take this one. I don't think that's hers, is it?
It's not. That's
this hand this time. That was the other one this last time.
Laughed.
Tiffany, please repeat after me. Tiffany,
Tiffany,
with this ring,
with this ring,
I gladly marry you.
I gladly marry you.
and join my life to yours.
Join my life to yours.
If you take that in. Jesse, oh, please repeat after me. Jesse,
with this ring,
I gladly marry you and join my life to yours. In accordance with the great state of California, you, Jesse, and you, Tiffany, are married. Please kiss your bride. If you'll join me in a brief prayer. Father, please look upon Jesse and Tiffany with favor. Bless their lives together with health and happiness, and help them commit and choose to focus on the other instead of themselves. In your son's name we pray, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you, Jesse and Tiffany Koo.